Do you believe in premonitions?
Premonitions?
Yes. You know, I've always had a great sense of tomorrow. I mean, when I'm dressing or eating or brushing my teeth, at the back of my mind, there's something else going on, you know. I find that I'm thinking about what I'll be doing next Saturday or next month or next year, in a fake kind of way, I mean. Well, tonight, before you came, I was aware of something missing. I realized I wasn't thinking of next month, or even next Saturday. When I tried to think of them, nothing came. Sounds absurd, but I found it most disconcerting.
So you're afraid of death, Alex?
Oh, devilishly. They say never confess a weakness to a woman, but I am. Devilishly.
You've a lot to lose.
Well, it's true, I've lost a great deal already. To pretend otherwise would be extremely ungracious of me.
Did you mean what you said today after rehearsal?
You mean when I called you an offensive imbecile? Oh, yes.
No, when you said you were going to tell Carol.
Christine, I'm extremely tired of this subject.
Did you mean it?
Judge for yourself. I don't wish to be rude, but I'd rather listen to Beethoven.
Promise you won't.
This is one of those occasions when my nerves are taut, when foolery drives me very nearly mad.
You must promise me.
Could you believe me if I promised? I'm going upstairs for my coat. What's the matter with you? What in heaven's name have you got there?
You bought it for me, remember? When I moved into the studio. For my protection, you said.
Give me that nonsensical object. I've seen this sort of thing before. Give it to me.
You keep away from me.
Don't you try to intimidate me.
You're not going to tell Carol. You're not going to see him after the performance. You're not ever going to see him again. Swear me you won't.
I'll swear nothing. I'll do what I please, see whom I please, say what I please. You fool. You cowardly, hysterical fool. You and your